Welcome and welcome back, everyone. This is the second session of the sixth meeting on quantum optics and quantum information, COVID-5. So without further delay, let me introduce the first speaker, Belkıs Akgökbulut from Boğaziçi University. So her talk is titled Enhanced Spontaneous Emission of Fluorescent Molecules Coupled into Quasi-Optical Modes in Random Media.
Okay. Today my presentation is about enhanced spontaneous emission of fluorescent molecules coupled into quasi-optical modes in random media. First of all, I will talk about spontaneous emission rate. The modification of spontaneous emission is considered to be at the heart of light matter interaction in the area of photonics after Einstein's proposal in 1917 that spontaneous emission would occur if radiation and matter are to realize thermal equilibrium. So in Einstein's proposal, spontaneous emission rate was considered to be an inherent property of matter and it is directly proportional to equation one. And after that, density of electromagnetic modes was defined by Paul Dirac in 1927. So finally, Edward Purcell in 1946 declared the fact that the probability of spontaneous emission is controlled by geometry of space. So when a quantum source is placed inside a photonic cavity structure, the density of photon states changes to allow controlling the spontaneous emission rate of the emitters. So in our study, I mean, quasi-optical modes, artificial photonic cavities are created to alter the spontaneous emission dynamics of the quantum sources by manipulating the density of electromagnetic states based on Anderson localization. Firstly, Anderson localization is a wave phenomena which originates from the interference of the electromagnetic waves in random structures. So multiple elastic light scattering in a disordered medium may cause creation of various artificial photonic cavities which are capable of trapping photons at particular frequencies and rendering them to have distinctive spectral and spatial profiles. So the nature of the Anderson localized modes is similar to that of the optical modes produced by commercially fabricated well-designed photonic cavities. In the first part of our study, transverse Anderson localized modes are firstly generated inside a simple wedge-type optical waveguide, as you see here, through excitation of the dye molecules embedded into the structure. A probing beam entering the disordered medium of the waveguide structure, consisting of air inclusions within the polymeric medium of the waveguide, is demonstrated here. The different colored regions, as you see here, describe the intensity distribution of the interference pattern due to transverse Anderson localization. In our study, transverse Anderson localized modes are accomplished through several single optical modes appearing at different emission wavelengths within the spectral bandwidth of rhodamine 6G dye molecules. And the photonic design of the structure allows guidance of single dominant Anderson mode and suppression of the others. In the second part of the study, the hyperbolic optical waveguides, which enable generation of single, double, and multiple Anderson localizations, are also formed to investigate the effect of an individual localized cavity on the spontaneous emission dynamics of the quantum sources. So the wedge-type optical waveguides are produced inside a triangular air hole, as you see here, which is embedded into a few silica optical material. So the solution of rhodamine 6G and phenol is being thrown into the air hole by Kepler process. As the solution is incorporated into the structure, randomly distributed air bubbles with various dimensions are formed during the Kepler process to serve as scattering medium for the photons. The corners of the air hole provides us three-dimensional wedge-type optical waveguides, as you see here, with distinctive characteristics. So the SAM and fluorescence microscopic images of the cross-sectional faces of the wedge-type optical waveguides are demonstrated in figure A and B, respectively. So waveguide one within this rectangular region is depicted in detail in figure C, as you see here, to actually understand, I mean, to tell the Anderson localization and to show the actually capillary effect within the waveguide structure. In our study, transverse Anderson localization arises from the interference of the electromagnetic waves in this kind of disordered polymeric waveguide medium. A fluorescent molecule is excited by a laser beam and also air bubbles, which are illustrated by these blue colored spheres, serve as scattering centers within the polymeric medium. So when the localization length is comparable with the wavelength of light, then the scattered light waves return to the same spot to constitute a loop, trapping photons at particular frequencies and generating Anderson localized modes. So the hyperbolic optical waveguides are also produced inside this 3D microtubule deltoid shaped cross-sectional area, as you see here, using the same capillary process at the same conditions. So the SAM and fluorescence microscopic images of the hyperbolic optical waveguides are demonstrated in figure A and B respectively. So each waveguide shown as bright spots in this figure actually ensures a number of coupled optical modes based on geometry and thickness of the waveguide itself. So this figure also shows the excitation of a dipole embedded into the hyperbolic optical waveguide structure. So in our experiment, I mean, time-resolved experiments based on time-correlated single photon counting technique are performed to characterize the coupling dynamics between the specific dye molecules and the specific Anderson localized modes at certain frequencies. So in the optical setup used in our experiments is demonstrated here. In our study, I mean, transverse Anderson localized modes actually are explored firstly through sharp spectral resonant peaks by photoluminescent spectra of the dye molecules under high excitation power at the wavelength of 550 nanometers, as you see here. Once an Anderson localized mode is obtained, then high power laser beam is blocked by shutter, and then time is of fluorescence lifetime measurements are performed to investigate the spontaneous emission dynamics of the dye molecules coupled into the individual localized optical modes. So the experimentally obtained 2D and 3D fluorescence intensity distributions of the dye molecules coupled into single Anderson localized mode in which waveguide 1 are demonstrated in figure A and B. In our study, I mean, the emitted light is collected from the sample phase through our confocal microscopic setup. And when the background signal is removed from figure A, then this sharp spectral resonant peak, like a lasing spot confined between two cavity walls, is obviously seen. So the fluorescence lifetime decay curves of the excited emitters coupled into the Anderson localized modes in which waveguide 1 and also in bulk material are demonstrated in figure A. The characteristics of the decay populations of the own resonant emitters of mode 1, mode 2, and mode 3 are observed to be quite different from one another, which elucidates that actually the emissions from the dye molecules coupled into the optical modes are localized with distinctive electromagnetic states due to the random configurations of the scattering centers within the polymeric medium. So the corresponding PL spectra of the dye molecules coupled into mode 1, mode 2, and mode 3 also are demonstrated here. Each optical mode appears at random spectral and spatial position within the actually spectral bandwidth of rhodamine 6G dye molecules. So in our study, I mean, to understand the random nature of the light localization in an entirely three-dimensional disordered waveguide medium, our time-resolved experiments based on time-correlated single photon counting technique actually are performed systematically at least 10 times. I mean, at the same conditions and using the same capillary tube. And each time after the specific Anderson localized mode is obtained, then its decay rate is recorded by our optical setup. So this figure shows the fluorescence lifetime distribution of the emitters coupled into the specific Anderson localized modes in the wedge waveguide structure. The spontaneous emission rate enhancement factors of the emitters coupled into quasi-optical modes actually is calculated to be changing from 2 to 7 according to our experimental results. So the variance of the enhancement factors is also calculated to characterize the random nature of the light localization in an entirely two-dimensional disordered waveguide medium based on this equation, which is equal to 2.5 according to our experimental results. And this value is comparable with the previously reported variance values of the postal factors for the Anderson localized modes, I mean, generated inside the disordered photonic crystal waveguide structures. And in our study, I mean, the total fluorescence originates from both on resonant and off resonant emission. The on resonant emission is attributed to the fastest decay rate in the total PL, which is corresponding to the emitters coupled into the specific Anderson localized cavities in the waveguide medium. And the theoretical and experimental enhancement factors are also calculated based on these two equations. In the theoretical enhancement factor, the first term represents the Purcell formula, and second and third terms represent the spectral and spatial mismatching between the individual dye molecules and the specific Anderson localized modes. Since in our study, actually, Anderson localized modes appear at random spectral and spatial positions, and also the dye molecules are also randomly distributed within the waveguide structure in our study. Their coupling into the specific Anderson nucleotides modes are distinctive for each case. So the taking average of actually these parts gives us the average value of the spontaneous emission rate enhancement factor in our study. The mode volume values are also calculated based on these two equations. And the mode volume values are also numerically calculated, actually. When we look at the results, we can clearly say that actually they are in very good agreement with each other. Similar results from the Anderson localized modes were also obtained by disordered photonic crystal waveguide structures, as seen in these two figures. I mean, strongly localized Anderson modes were generated by adding an extra disorder to a well-designed photonic crystal cavity structure. So as the strongly localized Anderson peaks appear, in random spectral and spatial positions, as you see in figure C, the spontaneous emission rate of the quantum emitters was demonstrated to be enhanced by a factor of 15 on resonance with the specific Anderson localized mode in this study. So the numerical calculations also have been performed by 3D finite difference time domain technique, and the electric field distribution profiles of the radiating dipoles coupled in the single Anderson localized mode in which waveguide 1 are demonstrated here in these figures. Each random configuration of the scattering centers is observed to give a different localization of the electromagnetic waves in our study. As it is clearly seen from these figures, that it is also illustrated that actually when the thickness of the waveguide is about 600 nanometers, then the photonic design of the structure allows guidance of single dominant Anderson mode and suppression of the others, similar to our experimentally obtained results. So the electric field intensity distribution profile of a radiating dipole, three coupling in the three distinctive Anderson localized cavities in which waveguide 2 is also demonstrated in figure A, which shows that increasing the thickness of the waveguide allows multimode guidance of the electromagnetic waves, Anderson localized modes. So it is also experimentally verified by the PL spectrum of the dye molecules coupled into Anderson localized modes in which waveguide 2, as you see here in figure B. It shows three sharp spectral resonance peaks corresponding to three different Anderson localized modes at different emission wavelengths. So the PL spectra of the dye molecules through coupling in the single mode, double mode, and multimode Anderson localizations in hyperbolic optical waveguides are demonstrated here. So each waveguide has specific optical and geometrical properties to have distinctive guidance mechanism for the Anderson localized modes. So the fluorescence decay curves of the excited emitters coupled into the Anderson localized cavities in hyperbolic optical waveguides and also in bulk material are demonstrated here. It is clearly seen that, an obvious change in the characteristics of the decay populations of the emitters coupled into the Anderson localized modes with reference to the emitters in bulk material is seen clearly from this figure. So the electric field distribution profiles of the dye molecules, of the dipoles of the dye molecules through coupling in the single mode, double mode, and multimode Anderson localizations in hyperbolic optical waveguides are also demonstrated here, which also confirms our experimental results for the hyperbolic optical waveguide structures. So in our study, to prove the occurrence of Anderson localizations, the numerical calculations have been performed by removing the scattering centers from the polymeric medium of the waveguide structure. So which means, as you see here in figure A, no air bubble inclusions within the polymeric medium. So as it is clearly seen that the strongly localized light governed by the scattering centers within the polymeric waveguide medium disappears to allow guidance of highly extended waveguide mode radiating from the dipole. So the impact of Anderson localization is also confirmed by reducing the refractive index contrast between the host polymeric medium and the scattering centers of the air bubbles, actually. So by taking the refractive index of the host medium to be constant and gradually decreasing the refractive index of the scattering centers from the values of 1.5 to 1.1, which shows that scattering strength plays a crucial role in Anderson localization. So all in all, in the final simulations, so the electric field distribution profiles coupled into the Anderson localized mode in hyperbolic optical waveguides also are manifested here to explore the localization dynamics of the optical modes in which the regime of Anderson localization is elucidated. So according to our numerical calculations, we can clearly say that the scattering strength, reducing the scattering strength and also filling fraction factor of the scattering centers decrease the impact of transverse Anderson localization. And finally, I can clearly say that the transverse Anderson localization in an entirely three-dimensional disordered waveguide medium is achieved for the first time by our studies. And in addition to this, the coupling of quantum sources into the specific Anderson localized cavities is also demonstrated as an alternative to actually manipulate the density of photon states and to alter the spontaneous emission rate of the quantum emitters, I mean, significantly. So thank you for listening. These are the related journal articles.
Thank you, Berkus, for this nice and well-timed presentation. So I think we can take one or two questions while I check the chat box. Let me ask you the first question. So I know Anderson localization depends on the dimensionality. So here you have this hyperbolic geometry. Does it, what's the role and does it, is it because of some practical concern that you are choosing this or?
Yeah, that is hyperbolic waveguide structure. Yes, that is actually, of course, it depends on dimensionality, but actually that is a micro tube. I mean, that's a Kepler tube in microscale, but we are obtaining the Anderson localization in our study from the actually those parts. And those parts actually, as you see here, the waveguide, the dimension of this waveguide, for instance, is about 500 nanometers. So it always actually allows guidance of one single dominant Anderson mode in this study. I mean, of course, that is a microtube in microscale, but we are taking the Anderson localization from that cross section and it is its dimension is about 500 nanometers. And also Anderson localization actually arises from the interference of the electromagnetic waves in this kind of disordered polymeric medium. I mean, the scattering dimensions of the scattering centers also actually are so important, are crucial to obtain Anderson localization in our study.
Thank you. So Humaira Chavlayan is asking, what is the length of the waveguide? Maybe you showed or mentioned, but
yeah, actually the waveguide, it is very long. It is 4 centimeters, which is long enough for backscattering of the photons, actually. And also it is also long enough to transmit the excitation beam into the waveguide structure.
Thank you. I don't see any other questions at the moment. So considering the time, I suggest that we move on and go ahead with the second talk.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you again.